In this video, I want to present an analysis of how the flow rate of an intermediate product in a series reaction depends on the conversion of the feed and the relative rate constant. So I'm looking at a first order series reaction. A goes to B, and the B can subsequently react to C, indicated the rate constant. So I'm talking about the relative values of these rate constants, and we're interested in this intermediate product B. Isothermal plug flow reactor, we're going to just use representative values. So I'm not even putting units here because I just want to show the relative behavior. So I'm going to look at K1 equals 2 just because it gives us reasonable looking graphs to visualize. And then three values of K2. So three different ratios of K2 to K1. Flow rate of A is 1. The volumetric flow rate also 1. Only A enters the reactor. And then what we want to do is look at a plot of how the flow rate of B. So this is molar flow rate we're talking about. So flow rate of B would be moles per hour, for example. How does that depend on the conversion of A? So the conversion is the flow rate of A coming in minus the flow rate of A leaving the reactor. So that's the, if you like, the amount per time reacting over the flow rate coming in. So we'll look at a plug flow reactor. Only A enters the reactor, but A, B, and C leave. The volume, our independent variable we're going to use, and this is 0 at the inlet, and the volume is our final volume at the outlet. So essentially, we just need to write down mass balances and solve them for this system. We won't do it analytically. We'll do it numerically to make it easy to graph the results and change the values. And so what we're going to do is look at mass balance for A. This is the change in the molar flow rate of A respect to this cumulative volume. This is the rate of reaction of A, which is the rate constant times the concentration. Mass balance for B is going to have two terms. We're forming B in the first reaction, so plus K1 times the concentration of A, and then we're reacting it in the second. And then the change in the flow rate of C respect to volume is going to be the rate constant 2 times the concentration of B. But what we're interested in is how this flow rate of B depends on the conversion of A coming into the reactor. So to solve these differential equations, we need initial conditions, which means at the inlet, at V equals 0, FA0 is equal to 1, FB0 and FC0 are equal to 0. So to solve these differential equations, we need additional variable. That's the concentration and the flow rate need to be related. So the concentration is the molar flow rate over the volumetric flow rate. And likewise, the concentration of B, the molar flow rate over the volumetric flow rate. We don't need the concentration of C in this case. And the volumetric flow rate is given as 1. So we have everything we need. We can substitute this in, and what we're going to use here is polymath to solve these ordinary differential equations. And so here is the polymath program on the left, shows the differential equations, their initial conditions for the three differential equations, the rate constants, this inlet flow rate, the conversion calculations, the relation between concentration, the molar flow rates, and these constants. This is our starting value to integrate. We actually then integrate it for this particular case only up to 3 because that was sufficient for the conversion. And so what I'm showing is three plots. This is the molar flow rate, FB on the y-axis, conversion, the fraction conversion of A. And the three plots correspond to these three values of the rate constants, or if you like, the ratio. So K2 over K1. So ratio K2 over K1 is equal to, in this case, 0.1, here it's 0.4, and here it's 10. So if K2 is small, then we can get a very high flow rate of B. Only at very high conversions of A do we convert a large amount of the B to C. And then as we increase the rate constant for the second reaction, you can see we dramatically decrease what's the flow rate of B that we can obtain. And we also dramatically decrease where the maximum occurs as a function of conversion. So depending on these values of the rate constant, to maximize our flow rate of B for a given system, we have to pick here, for example, the conditions where we want to run the reactor, what the residence time would be so that we only have a small conversion of A in order to maximize the flow rate of B, or alternatively try to change this ratio typically by changing the temperature because they would have different activation energies. For example, the activation energy of the first reaction is higher than the activation of the second reaction, then by raising the temperature we can get relatively more B out. But for series reaction, conversion to the desired product, molar flow rate of our desired product depends very much on the residence time in the reactor.